Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about the electrophoresis, and in that case we have got to know that how the charged particles that are present on the dispersed phase, they get deposited on their oppositely charged electrode. So similar to that fact, we are going to talk about the coagulation as well as the Schulze-Hardy rule. So what is coagulation and what is Schulze-Hardy rule based on the coagulation? So let us talk about this in this lecture. So let us understand the definition of the coagulation and what does this mean. Let us talk about that. So the coagulation is basically is defined as a precipitation of the colloidal particles, and we know that colloidal particles are of positive charge or can be of negative charge. But this kind of attraction or this kind of attraction of the colloidal particles towards the other particles so as to form a larger molecule or a larger particle is basically known as precipitation that we know. But this kind of phenomenon that takes place because of the colloidal particles which are basically charged pieces, because of which that could be called as a coagulation. And what happens is, so in this case basically the removal of the charge that is present on the colloids that can be removed, because of which we can understand that if the colloidal particles, if they are of suppose positive charge, and suppose if an electrolyte has been added in it, and in that case suppose the electrolyte consists of cation as well as NN, so the oppositely charged species with respect to that of the colloidal particle, they will get associated with each other so as to form a larger molecule, and that kind of larger molecule is basically because of the precipitation that has occurred. So now this kind of precipitation is basically known as coagulation, and that is what we are going to talk about in a very deep detail. So let us talk about that. So we know that the colloidal particles can be positive or can be negative. So we can coagulate those kind of particles, that is with more other particles. How? Suppose if we have a colloidal solution, and suppose if we have added that is an electrolyte. So if we have added an electrolyte, and that electrolyte consists of that is cation as well as NN, and suppose that colloidal particle that is suppose of positive charge, because we have understood that colloids can be positive or negative in our previous lecture also. Suppose if that colloidal is of positive charge, and of which it has to neutralize the charge on it, that is to neutralize that we need basically a minus charged species. So therefore that positively charged colloidal particle will try to associate the negatively charged species of the electrolyte towards itself, so as not only one particle of or not only the one species of the electrolyte that would attach on it, but multiple negative species, or we could say like multiple anions, can be associated with the positively charged colloidal particle. So in this case, the colloidal particle has turned into a molecule or turned into a particle which is of larger size compared to that of the earlier one. So now this kind of process that has occurred is known as coagulation, and that is what we have a concept of, that is lyophobic as well as lyophilic zone that we have talked in our previous lecture also. But meanwhile, let us talk about the Schulze-Hardy rule. So what is Schulze-Hardy rule? Let us talk about that one. So talking about the first rule, that is the first rule according to Schulze-Hardy rule, and it says that the ions of the added electrolytes, that is suppose if we are adding the electrolyte in the colloidal solution. So the ions of the added electrolytes in the colloidal solution helps in neutralizing the charge on the colloidal particle. So this is what we have discussed like earlier only. How? Because suppose if the colloidal particle consists of negative charge, so we have to remove that negative charge on it. So this is only possible if we add the electrolyte. And in that electrolyte, suppose it consists of cation as well as NN. So in this case, basically, the cation of the electrolyte that will be associated with the negatively charged colloidal particle. So making to remove the negatively charged or negative charge of, which is on the colloidal particle by neutralizing it. So it is not only neutralizing it, but it is making or the cations of the electrolyte, they are basically helping not only to remove the negative charged that is, this cations are not only helping to remove the charge on the colloidal particle, but they are also associating it with the colloidal particle, making it to be a larger particle. So therefore, this is what the Schulze-Hardy rule is. So this is the first point that we are talking about, and now let us talk about the second point. So the second point of the Schulze-Hardy rule is basically the precipitating power of the electrolyte depends on the charge of the cation and anion of the electrolyte. So what does the precipitating power mean? The precipitating power means so as an ability to remove the charge on the colloidal particle by associating it, or basically it is known as precipitation. So this happens while the removal of the charge, but it depends on that how much affinity of the negative charge species of that is electrolyte or positive charge species of the electrolyte is. So it depends on the charge of it. So how does it depends on that? Let me talk about that with the help of an example. For example, if we have that is sodium ion, basically it is sodium cation, which has a positive charge, and we have basically another that is Mg2 plus and another one that is Al3 plus. So in this case, basically, as I have said earlier only that it depends on the charge of the cation or anion. So in this case, we could say that is Al3 plus has a more positive charge. So therefore, this will have more precipitizing power or coagulating power. So therefore, we could say that this will coagulate more, and this will be this will have more affinity towards the colloidal particle by removing the charge on it and by neutralizing it, compared to that of Mg2 plus and compared to that of Na plus. So this was related to the cation. So these are the examples of the cation, and talking about the anions, and we can talk about them. That is Cl minus. The next one I would say the SO4 2 minus, and the next one is that is PO4 3 minus. So if I compare this one, then the one which will have more charge, or that could be negative also, but it depends on the magnitude. So therefore, for which we could say that PO3 minus or PO4 3 minus, that would be having. So talking about that is PO4 3 minus, so that would have basically more that is a precipitating power compared to that of SO4 2 minus and compared to that of Cl minus. So therefore, this plays a very vital role, and because these are the electrolytes, they are the part of the electrolytes. So therefore, this could be able to basically neutralize, not only to neutralize but so as to form a precipitate with that of the colloidal particle. So this is what the rules of the Schulze and Hardy rule that I was talking about. But let me give a conclusion in this case. That is, we have talked about that is lyophobic soles as well as the lyophilic soles. So the reason behind that is the lyophilic soles, they require more electrolyte. The reason behind that is because of the dispersed phase and the dispersed medium in the when we are talking about the lyophilic soles. So they are very much attracted towards each other. But somehow we have two that is precipitated by adding electrolyte. But since the dispersed phase as well as the dispersed medium, they are attractive towards each other in a very strong way compared to that of the lyophobic one. So therefore, more electrolytes are being needed. So more electrolytes will not only they will try to remove the charge on it, but they will also try to that is form a precipitate on it. So because of this dispersed medium that has more affinity towards the dispersed phase, so therefore more electrolytes are being needed so as to form a coagulation, and that's the reason that the lyophilic soles require more electrolytes. Well, similarly, if I am talking about the lyophobic soles or lyophobic colloids, so in this case, the dispersed phase as well as the dispersed medium, they don't have that much of attraction. So even though if we are adding a small amount of electrolyte, so that would be able to cover up the colloidal particle, and not only cover up the colloidal particle, but it will also neutralize it, but it will cover with the several particles on it. So that's the reason that the coagulation of the colloidal particle can happen. And this is how the coagulation can be done, or we could say like precipitation can be done. So that was it, and that's it. So that is what I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know about the concept of coagulation and the Schulze and Hardy rule. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.